G'day everyone, I'm the Hat Hobbit and welcome back to another episode of Surviving with Hobbit. Today, we're doing a little Christmas special. I've already done quite a bit of preparation and gathered a lot of leaves, a lot of wood, and we're going to do some fun stuff because if I just put my armor back on, we're going to use leaves to make some redstone creations. So we might as well just jump straight into it. So yeah, if you're wondering where I am, I'm just on top of the mountain where we went that one time. You can see our house down there. If you're wondering why I'm not using Optifine, it's because Optifine hasn't been released for 1.15 yet. So that is definitely down the line and we'll get there eventually. So I might as well just get started with building. So I'm thinking for a base of the tree, because knowing about sort of size of the piston and stuff, we can use a 3x3 base, which will gradually taper off into a 1x1, maybe? I don't know, I'll think of something, because we're going to want to have stuff on the inside of this, which is mainly redstone-related stuff. So yeah, we're doing quite a bit of redstone this episode, which is going to be very weird. I'm about to run out of wood already, and I'm realizing that I definitely did not prepare enough for this episode. Ah, dear. It's honestly typical, isn't it? I mean, dear. I'm going to have to go grab some more wood in a second. But, I mean, you get a sort of idea of how we're going to start this. Basically, what we're going to do is gradually up the tree, we're going to take out sort of holes in certain places. So I'm thinking probably first one maybe here. And what we'll do is using sticker pistons, if we put a sticker piston there, and then I'm going to use actually going to use dark oak because it blends better with, the spruce, as you can see here. If I just put that there, what that'll allow me to do, and actually what I should do is probably put it like that and then just push the piston into it. We're going to do some redstone leaves today. So as you can see, I've got a bunch of leaves in my inventory, and I'm just going to demonstrate this with oak leaves because it's the easiest to do. But basically, and I'm hoping my redstone lamps won't break because I haven't got too many of them. What we're going to do is, whenever a observer reads a change of log from a leaf, it basically sends out redstone impulse, and I'm going to see if I can try and show you this. I should have brought like a lever or something. Wait a minute, I can make a lever. There we go. So as you can see, when there's an update to the log here, basically, so the log moves in and out of this position here. Obviously, this will be covered up by other leaves. But when that changes, it sends a redstone impulse through here to the observer, which picks it up and then sends a pulse to this lamp. So I thought, why not use this to make Christmas lights? So we're going to have to create sort of like a redstone clock, which just gradually changes these, and we're going to have sort of two circuits. And I think it's going to look really cool in the end of things, but obviously, we've got to build it first, which might take a little while, and it's turning to night. Fantastic. Let me just get some torches up. Okay, so since the little demonstration was actually quite a success, yep, that's fine. Okay. Basically, what we'll do is just get everything sorted. Well, I mean, obviously, my brain ain't working today. I've been ill quite recently, hence the lack of videos. But what am I trying to say? Where's my cobble gone? I swear I had like a stack of cobble. Oh, there it is. Never mind. Just being silly again. Anyway, let's just grab a little bit of scaffolding up, because we obviously have a lot of work to be doing. I'm actually recording this on Christmas Eve, so if I want to get this in time for Christmas, because this is technically a Christmas special, Merry Christmas, everybody, I'm going to have to get this all edited and recorded by the end of the day, which, it takes longer than you'd think, but I'm going to go grab a little bit more spruce wood, and then we'll continue onwards. Alright, so I've gone back and got another stack of wood. So I'm thinking probably next Christmas light maybe
here?
Or is that too high? Actually, you know what? What we'll probably do is we'll stick it here again. Then the next one here. Maybe. Or is that too close? Because I think that might be too close together. That's my concern. I keep falling down. I've got to stop falling down. That's the big problem we've got. Let me think. Because this tree is already quite high, by the looks of things, if I just, yeah, so it's quite, it's reasonably tall and it's reasonably thick. And we have only got 5 sticky pistons, which I have realized and feel like a complete deuce. So unless, for some miraculous reason, if Minecraft decides I'm going to have a full moon, we'll be able to get more slime from our swamp over there. But otherwise, we're not going to have many sort of Christmas lights controlled by pistons, which would be quite frustrating. And the music kicks in, very nice. But I think what we'll probably do is do another one here. And then maybe start building it woods, because, I mean, what we can do is, instead of using redstone ones, is just have some just constantly glowing ones, which I think will look pretty, quite pretty. And then we'll obviously put a star on the top. But for that, we're going to actually have to start bringing stuff in. And then we're going to have to start, obviously, building up the redstone on the inside. So I'll get back when I've sort of built this up a little bit more, I think. And we'll sort of continue from there. So I'll be right back. Chances are I'm going to need to go get some more wood anyway. So I've got to stop doing that. I should really get some food as well. I've just noticed that my hunger is basically at half. Ah, dear, dear. What am I doing? I'm not prepared for this at all. Okay, that was just not a smart thing to do. Time to go back and get my stuff. You know, I honestly can't remember where I put Mary G. I might need to maybe look back at the footage, which I've already recorded, and then hopefully find him. I mean, I don't actually remember where I put him. I've got a few ideas where he could be, so we'll obviously check over there and, well, over in those places. But if I don't find him, I'm going to have to look back through a few of my episodes towards the ends of them to see if I can find him. Ah, dear. Because obviously I want Mary G to be here for the great switch on, if we can actually get this to work, because chances are we won't be able to. But, what we'll probably do is, well, obviously I'll go back and look through the footage to try and find him, and hope that we do find him. If we don't find him, I'm not sure what I'd do, but, dear. So, anyway, so I'm gonna quickly grab myself that stack of cobble. Where is it gone? There it is. And just sort of plumb my way up back to the top and just sort of continue building. I definitely haven't gotten enough wood to properly continue work, but I mean, I've got enough to sort of do a little bit at least, because I mean, I still don't know how big I want to make this. But I know I don't want to make it absolutely massive, because, like, we don't have that much resources at the moment, and I think if we did have a few more resources, we would make it a lot bigger, but we don't have a lot of resources, and it's somewhat stressful knowing that. Okay, so, since we're nearing somewhat the top of this quite blocky looking tree, I would break it up a little bit with more blocks, but it's quite difficult to organize that with the lack of resources that I have. I think if I put this here, put this here. Does that look tall enough? Or does this just look like a giant pencil? Because I have a feeling it's going to look like a giant pencil, and then I'm going to be very sad, but... It just looks like a giant pencil. I mean, it's kind of hard to tell, because it's quite hard to see it, but... Yeah, that just looks like a giant pencil. I think we need to bring that part of the tree up a little bit more, and then pillar that a little bit more. So I'm going to go grab some more wood, and then we'll get right to that. Alright, I'm being extra careful now, because I've put in a few more sort of blocks of wood. About half a stack, I'd say. So how does that look from a distance? There we go, that looks a little bit better. I mean, I'll probably mess around with some of the parts up here just to make it look a little bit more natural going into that. So maybe I'm thinking if we just cut away that, put some blocks in there. Maybe try that. Yeah, just making it look, just roughing it up a little bit, just to make it look that little bit more sort of like grown looking tree rather than sort of man made. I'll probably bring it out a little bit more towards the bottom. See, that just looks kind of weird up there, so I'm gonna grab a little bit of wood and just sort of fix that. That was not what I wanted to do. Okay. We'll actually thicken up the base a little bit, I think, as well. So, just... Just create sort of some root-looking things, perhaps. I don't know what I'm doing, so... I mean, I guess that looks alright. Potentially. Maybe if we put some more sort of around here, so maybe some smaller ones. Might actually see if I can grab some wood from somewhere that I don't need it to be. Which, that obviously is not an option there. I think this is actually looking pretty decent. I mean, maybe if we mix in some dark oak, that might actually look quite nice. Yeah. Obviously not full-on dark oak, because that just looks quite horrible. But maybe just mixing it in just a little bit, so maybe here. Yeah, there we go. That actually looks quite nice. Like, the subtle differences in between the two different types of wood. So maybe if we do that. Like, just like that in a few places. Just where, like, the bark's dried up a little bit, perhaps. Because I think that'll look pretty cool. Alright, this is actually coming out quite nicely, I think. Hello. I'm just going to let you do your thing. It's Christmas, so please don't attack. That's a request, not an order, but it is Christmas. Please don't attack me. I really don't know how this is looking. It probably looks fine, but I mean, I just like to do a little bit of detailing. That just that does not look like a tree. Oh no, it's Christmas. Honestly, just leave me do my thing, man. Let me Christmas. I think I'm just gonna quickly. That's why I was gonna update the textures, because. Oh boy. That's not nice having just a massive lava pool here. Oh my lord. What? The horde are coming. I suppose it is nighttime, but. I'm just trying to build a Christmas tree. Leave me be. I mean, I suppose when I get the leaves on, it might look a little bit better. But I mean, for the time being, it's looking all right, I guess. Maybe. I mean, let's get some of the sticky pistons in, because obviously we need to start actually building the lights of this tree, because otherwise we're not going to get this done this episode, and that's going to be sad if we don't, because it's like, that's what we wanted to do this episode. So there's one. Do I still have that lever? I think I threw it away and now I'm regretting it. Of course. Right. Yeah, so that is actually really dark up there, so I'm going to there we go. Alright. Let's just build up a little bit, get all the pistons in place, and hope that we can somehow manage to do this. Because I have an idea of how I'm going to do it, but it might be quite awkward, and because I am nowhere near the best redstone. Where did I put my pistons? There they are. Okay. I'm playing on a monitor that I'm not very used to at the moment, so apologies if I'm a big derp. So next one sort of has to go in the middle, because it's actually quite awkward positioning. I think I'm actually just going to move this, because it's just going to make life a lot easier for me when building. I didn't even pick up that piece of spruce, did I? Let's make it dark oak. Make it dark oak, because it fits in. So let's see. Yep, another piston there. Maybe another piston. Yeah, so there's one more, which is we're going to have to put it in sort of that way. So if we put that there, and then... No, that's not going to work at all, is it? Yeah, I'm going to have to build out a block or something. But we should be able to get this sorted quite easily. There we go, so... Actually, no, we're going to have to put it here on this block. Because, yeah, okay. So that needs to go there, and this needs to go there. It's already extremely cramped. I don't see any other way of getting down than possibly breaking that and then just knocking down like that. Alright, so I'm thinking we start putting in leaves and stuff, because we know where all the pistons and stuff are going to be, probably. So I think we need to start putting in smoke leaf sort of trails. Ah, baby zombie, baby zombie. No, 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 no. They're too fast. Baby zombies are way too fast, in my opinion. Although it does make them a challenge, to be fair, which is quite fun. I'm just sort of trying to build quite natural-looking leaves, which is harder than it looks. I mean, I haven't done it much myself normally, so I don't know actually how many leaves I'm going to need. But I'm just sort of randomly placing leaves at the moment, which hopefully does a decent job in sort of just starting off everything. Because obviously you don't want to make it look too natural. Sorry, too natural, too man-made. And that's obviously quite hard to do because you are making it handmade. I'm probably not going to have enough leaves for this either today. Ah, dear, dear, I'm going to have to be doing a lot of off-camera work. And hopefully have enough time to properly do this. So, where's the next one? Because I can't remember where I put it, because I think it's the next level up, right? So first one's there, second one is there. That's like a two-block jump. Is that observed? The answer to that is no. Okay. Let's quickly observe that. So it's that one there, I think. So grab some oak leaves. See, because that is really far out now. Now look at it. And that's probably because we need to put more leaves around the outside. So that's what I'll quickly do. I'm going to have to move my staircase. Yeah, I'm trying my best to make this look natural. And it's very difficult because, I mean, I'm not used to doing sort of these natural looking builds. At least we get a giant tree that we wanted. So let's just build up a little bit. Just so we can hop. Let's try that again, shall we? Just so we can hop.
Got it!
Just so we can hop onto our tree. And maybe then if we just extend this out a little bit more, we can build up to make it look somewhat integrated into the tree. Because we might need to just make it so a lot of these are a lot less sticking out. I just accidentally hit my microphone. Fantastic. But yeah, hopefully we can make it so it just looks like that. It looks much more natural looking within the tree. Because I don't often build trees in Minecraft, I'm going to be honest. It's not really something I'm used to doing. So I'm hoping this is going to turn out pretty nicely. I'm starting to realize how tall we actually made this, and I'm starting to regret how tall we made it. And I'm starting to realize that we probably don't need... we probably do need that big of a light now that I think about it, because... Ah, that was not a shift! I'm just not good at playing this game today, am I? I'm just not good at playing this game. Alright, so... this one looks alright. I mean, we could probably do with a little bit more leaves covering up like this. But that actually looks alright. It's just sort of making it so it sort of comes out more this way. Have we run out of leaves? We haven't run out of leaves quite yet, thankfully. But I know we are running out of leaves. Yeah, we got one stack after this, so I'm definitely going to have to go grab more of those. It's a never-ending task, this. Never-ending task. And we're out of leaves, and we're not even halfway up the tree, I don't think. Or are we? Actually, we're pretty close to halfway, I'd say. So... Oh, wait a minute. Where's the rest of the... Oh, there's another one. So that's a good thing we checked. Where's the dark oak? There's our dark oak logs. So we need one there. Let's just do straight up observe one for this one. Because it just makes our life easier. Then this one is actually just going to be an observer in the actual tree itself. So there we go. Just cover that up a little bit with some like leaves. Light. I think that's every... Well, let's see, we've got 1, 2, 3, counting before it, 4, 5. Okay, yeah, so that's all of our sticky pistons. And we still have 15 Christmas lights because, well, I say Christmas lights, 15 redstone lamps because I severely overestimated the amount of resources we have. I think if I just go take a look at this from the distance, I think it's actually looking all right. Like, I wouldn't say it's amazing because it's not. But that's kind of looking like the bottom of a Christmas tree, is it not? Yeah, okay. Right, I'm going to go grab some more leaves and, well, we'll take it from there. So I've just looked at my tree. It's a bit lopsided. But you know what? I actually somewhat love it in a weird sort of way. Yeah, I mean, I'll probably track back a little bit over here because it is pretty... It's a bit over the top on this side, like, lopsided wise. But, I mean, otherwise, I'm really starting to like it. Like, I think if we just add a little bit more leaf over here, or maybe actually over here more, and then just trimmed back a little bit more, I think it'll look alright. So, this is actually going better than I expected it to. Okay, so I thought I'd quickly just do the star at the top, because, I mean, this is going to be a somewhat permanent build, I'd say, because at this point, I highly doubt we're going to be able to tear this down very easily. So I thought, let's just start working on this sort of star thing at the top, because I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this, obviously. So I thought, why not make it into sort of like a beacon or something? Well, obviously not a real beacon, but because I'm in no way, shape or form ready to fight the Wither. But I think that looks pretty good star. I mean, well, obviously, let's just hop down here and take a look. Yeah, it looks all right, I think. That just big block of stuff is just going to annoy me, so I'll quickly fix that. But I think we're almost ready to move on sort of like to the actual lighting on this tree. I should have just made the whole tree as a massive sort of Christmas gradual sort of thing. Like, made it as sort of like a mini sub-series. Because this is quite the build. But it'll be worth it, in my opinion. It'll be worth it just having a super long episode for once. And we've run out of leaves again, so we need to go get more, but actually, no, I don't think we need to get any more. I think this looks all right. Like, it's not the best tree in the world, but then again, I'm not the best builder in the world. I might unsharpen that corner there, but because that is just a big block of leaves. So grab the leaves and just... grab the shears and just turn it back a little bit. But apart from that, I think this looks done. Like, in terms of actual build, like, no Christmas tree is perfect, nor is any build of mine, that is something I can basically just step away from and say I'm happy with that, because admittedly, at least, it's not like a perfect shape, but no Christmas tree really is. I mean, it looks kind of natural, in my opinion. I mean, sure, it doesn't look the most natural tree in the world, but it's good for me, who's never really built a tree before. So, I think, yeah, I'm happy with that. I mean, I don't know what you guys think, but I'm going to stick with this. So, on to the interior. So, I'm thinking we use redstone torches in quite an interesting way. So, redstone torches have an interesting sort of thing where you can sort of... I don't know how I'm going to do this with this, but basically, if you put a redstone torch, and I'll grab a few just to show it off. If you power a redstone torch, obviously, the torch turns off. So, you can sort of do, I guess, sort of torch trains upwards. If I can do that. Yeah, there you go. So, you can sort of see that torch is off because that one is on. So then, if you do, I'm going to do my best to demonstrate this, so if I do that, so that torch is powering that, which let's say this, which say is connected to this block. So when this block is turned on, it'll activate this piston, which will connect to that piece of wood, and then we'll pull it back and stuff like that. So if we get another lever, because I can't remember where I put the other one. Yeah, there we go. So that then activates like that. That activates like that. And that should turn on and off a light. Specifically that one, by the looks of things. So I was thinking, if we can set up a redstone clock, and I'm thinking maybe just a standard repeater clock, if I can remember how to craft them, which I almost certainly can't. But I will quickly check what we need, because we should be able to do it. That's easy. I can make that quite easily. But we should just be able to make a simple redstone clock, which activates this torch here. So, I'm glad we've done it. Ah! Spider! Why? I know it's Christmas, but... Hi. Anyway. If I set up sort of like a repeater clock here, so... I'm trying to think how that would be best to do it. But that'll basically power this torch chain up here. Which then we can use to power the rest of it, I suppose. I suppose that's what I'm getting at. I mean, it's kind of hard for me to explain it because I'm useless explaining things. But if we do torch... This is becoming interesting. I wonder, hold on, if I just go up here, because if I do I can't actually see. Maybe can you? I've got to stop doing that with my axe. That is the one thing that I keep doing with my axe, and I keep forgetting that it strips, like, wood. It's really annoying. But I might actually look alright. So if I do that, then maybe a dot of redstone? Will that work? Well, that powers that under there. Alright, let's get rid of a lot of this sort of scaffolding and just test it with a lever. What does that do? Trying to think how best to do this. I think that's all right, actually. I mean, it's not the most conventional ways of doing it, but I think it'll work. Yeah, all right. I'm going to go make some repeaters, and we'll set up a quick redstone clock and see what that does from the outside. And it might be quite loud, which I have a feeling is going to be interesting if it is. So I'll be right back. All right, well, the pistons are active. I think they can be a little bit faster. I mean, it is sparkling. And my redstone is a little bit exposed at the moment because that's all there, so let's just block that off. But I am noticing that one of them isn't sparkling. Stop for a second. I just kind of want to check why that one isn't working. So which one was it? It was... that one there. Okay, I roughly know what that is. Hey, there we go. Sorted. Wait, I need to get back up there. I need to get back up there. No! Stop. Stop, stop, stop. No! Wait, oh no, I've made a clock. Oh no. Oh no, it's all going wrong. Okay, let's try just getting down. I'll probably do it from the outside if I can. So I need to keep that one there. There we go. That works, I guess. Alright, so... clock is definitely working, and everything should be lighting up now. That's actually not too bad. I'm actually really happy with that. Using leaves and redstone. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. What have I come to? Alright, well, I'm pretty happy with that. I mean, I can't think I can see how I can improve it, because let's be honest, it is a lopsided tree. I'm getting attacked by owl angles, by spiders, zombies, and all of the other things. This is not fun at all. Please stop. It's Christmas. It's Christmas. Wait, what did you drop? I don't know what you dropped, but that's actually really pretty, in my opinion. Admittedly, I think maybe the clock could be a little bit slower so those don't just fire off every second, but like twice every second, but. You have an enchanted bow. Hello, I want your nice Christmas present. Give me your bow. You didn't give me your bow, why not? Whoops. But I think that's actually really pretty. I mean, that's going to be the thumbnail, I think. There we go. Very pretty. Ah, dear. Well, I think I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to wish you all a very Merry Christmas from the Hat Hobbit. If skeletons weren't shooting at me, that was... Dear. Right, let's try that again, shall we? So anyway, that is about all the time I've got today. I really do hope you enjoyed. I loved making this tree, so I hope you enjoyed watching me doing this. And I just hope you have a very Merry Christmas. I'm just going to leave it at that. No sort of, like, ask you to subscribe or anything like that. So with that, all I'm going to say is take care, Merry Christmas, and bye-bye.